The second presentation of this session is entitled AI-based combined scheduling and motion planning in flexible robotic assembly lines. And this contribution is from our colleagues from the Laboratory for Manufacturing Systems and Automation from University of Patras, Greece. The authors are Niki, Kousi, Dimosthenis, Dimosthenopoulos, Aleksandros-Stereos, Matthaiakis, George Michalos, and Sotiris Makris. We are looking for your presentation, Dimosthenis.
Hello, my name is Dimosthenopoulos Dimosthenis. I work as a research engineer in Laboratory for Manufacturing Systems and Automation, LMS. I would like to present you the paper entitled AI-based combined scheduling and motion planning in flexible robotic assembly lines. Under this presentation, the problem of mobile robots integration into dynamic production systems will be described. Additionally, the objectives of the proposed approach and the detailed implementation will be presented. The proposed system has been implemented in a case study inspired from the automotive industry, and based on the outcome, the conclusions and the outlook of this work will be listed. The traditional production is mostly based on fixed automation and manual production. The fixed automation is very efficient for massive productions, but it lacks flexibility, as the resources in the processes are fixed and pre-programmed. As a result, the introduction of new product variants is highly money and time consuming. On the other hand, manual production is highly flexible, but it creates ergonomic issues for the workers as they are forced to handle heavy loads. The latest trend to overcome these challenges is EU foster the human-robot collaboration, since it aspires to keep a low production cost and to increase factory reconfigurability by combining the skills of both humans and robots. A reconfigurable factory could be enabled by a smart robot control system. Inspired by that, an efficient decision-making framework is developed that targets on the dynamic work balancing among the human operators and robot resources and on the safe and efficient collaboration between them. The proposed system is able to monitor in real time the production status and make decisions about the task allocation based on the current resources availability and capabilities. In order to develop an effective control system, a multi-level decision-making approach is considered as the best strategy. As already mentioned, the ultimate goal is to distribute dynamically and efficiently the workload among the resources, taking into consideration real-time changes in working environment. To this end, the decisions made by the implemented framework are based on the two-way interaction between line-level and resource-level decision-making. This interaction is taking place via a dynamically updated digital twin. The digital twin exchanges data in real time with sensors, MRP motion planners, search-based algorithms, and multi-criteria decision-making algorithms in order to generate the optimal scheduling. The hybrid production systems are in most cases characterized by high complexity. In order to efficiently manipulate systems with that level of complexity, intelligent planning algorithms are required. To this end, the process and the working environment are modeled with respect to a hierarchical modeling using artificial intelligence techniques. As we can see in the figure, a five-level hierarchical structure has been used to model the process. The scheduling and the task allocation take place in layer 4, while the motion planning in layer 5. Also, for the facilities representation, a three-level breakdown of shop floor, assembly line, and assembly station has been implemented. The decision-making framework developed to manipulate hybrid production systems is based on some clearly defined principles and follows some strictly determined steps in order to achieve the most efficient task allocation among the resources. These steps are the following: resource suitability evaluation, generation of the alternative scenarios, evaluation criteria ranking, evaluation of the generated alternatives based on the selected decision-making criteria, selection of the highest scoring alternative as the optimal scheduling solution, and motion planning. Each of these modules will be presented in the upcoming slides. The resource suitability module is designed to prevent the task planner from time-consumingly evaluating unrealistic alternatives. The resource suitability evaluation function is based on the relation between each operation's needs and each resource's capabilities. For example, as presented in the figure, a screwing operation needs a specific screwdriver to be completed. So, the resource to assign to execute this operation must have this tool available. Another major factor in resource suitability evaluation is the parts handled in each operation and their individual characteristics, like their weight, for example, which must be lower than the suitable resource's payload. The next step in the decision-making process is the generation of the alternative tree. As it can be seen in the figure, each branch of the tree represents a complete alternative schedule. Each alternative is formed as a combination of a specific operation and the resource this operation is assigned to. The black boxes in the figure represent alternatives that were randomly selected by the decision algorithm not to be checked. Therefore, the scheduling process was terminated at this point. After forming the alternatives, the preferable evaluation criteria are selected and used to evaluate the generated scenarios through the digital twin. These criteria and their weight factors are pre-selected by the user based on the production system's needs and objectives. Under this implementation, the chosen decision-making criteria are minimizing part flow time, minimizing payload handled by the human operators, minimizing distance covered by the mobile robots, and maximizing resource utilization. All these criteria have been mathematically defined via equations. The value of each criterion is normalized and the utility value is calculated. The alternatives that are considered as feasible after the resource suitability control are evaluated and rated based on the utility value using the presented equation, and through this process emerges the highest scoring alternative as the optimal scheduling solution. As already mentioned, each alternative is simulated and evaluated via the digital twin. So, in order to simulate the execution of each alternative and take the information needed for the evaluation process, like time estimations, from the digital twin, the corresponding operations need to be translated into robot actions. This connection is proposed to be accomplished through a templated method. After experimenting, each individual type of operation has been linked to a group of robot actions, creating a unique template for each type of operation. These templates are filled with information about the real world through the digital twin as well, and are used to simulate the robot's behavior during each alternative. The whole framework architecture is based on the interaction between three individual subsystems. These systems are the following: the digital twin database. In this module are saved all the information and data about the process and the real world. The planning tool and criteria evaluation functions. These functions are responsible for generating the alternative tree and evaluating each alternative based on the selected criteria. The robot program generation. This module's role is to convert the operation-based schedule extracted by the task planner into a robot action-based executable program. All these modules are integrated in a central platform, allowing their online communication and exchange of data and information in real time. The proposed methodology has been applied to a collaborative scenario inspired by an actual production line of the automotive industry. In particular, the proposed framework has been implemented with the use of data from the front axle assembly line of a passenger vehicle. As presented in the figure, the current state of this assembly line involves four assembly stations where all the tasks included in the front axle assembly are taking place. Station 1, right damper assembly, Station 2, left damper assembly, Station 3, screwing operations, and Station 4, cabling station. In this case, the current production line employs three human operators in total. The main issues with this approach are ergonomic, as the human operators are forced to repeatedly carry and manipulate the 6 kg dampers. Also, this assembly line lacks flexibility, as the screwing machine is able to assemble only one car model, while the other two models that produced from this line are assembled manually. In the proposed production line, two MRPs will be introduced to take over some of the handling, inserting, and screwing operations. Thus, Station 4 will not be necessary anymore, as the operations taking place under this production phase will be transferred to Stations 1 and 2. Moreover, one of the MRP manipulators will undertake all the screwing operations, leading to the elimination of Station 3 as well. Also, under this approach, all three car models are produced from the assembly line. Finally, after the introduction of the robotic manipulators, only one human operator will be needed to work in the remaining stations, allowing the exploitation of the other two workers in different posts where the human capabilities are needed. Based on this case study, experiments and simulations were conducted in order to investigate the performance of the proposed system. Both systems were evaluated based on the same criteria metrics, and the arising results were used to compare their performances under the same conditions. Gantt charts and resource utilization diagrams are also presented for both manual and hybrid assembly model in order to compare the resources utilization. In this slide are presented the results for the manual assembly model. It is shown that under this approach, each human operator is only taking part in a small fraction of the overall production process. On the other hand, as presented in this resources utilization diagram, under the hybrid production model, the human operator contributes to a much greater degree in the overall production. By comparing the two models, it is evident that the hybrid production system presents higher performance validation metrics in every evaluation criterion used. The proposed approach achieved a significant reduction in flow time while reducing the payload handled by the human operators. As for the resources utilization, it is obvious based on the diagrams that under the hybrid production model is achieved a much more balanced task allocation among the resources. The idle time of each resource is significantly reduced, and the remaining human operators can be used in other, more intellectually demanding tasks. Summarizing, this case study discussed the implementation of a decision-making framework which combines efficiently scheduling and motion planning based on AI in robotic assembly lines. So, with implementation of this architecture can be achieved many significant goals, like optimal task allocation, easy rescheduling, optimal and realistic motion plans, and efficient exploitation of human capabilities. As for the future work that needs to be done, the identified next step for enhancing the proposed method is the implementation of the developed framework in larger scale application. Also, future studies should target on how the integration with the factory's legacy system will be accomplished. This work has been funded under EUH 2020 project Mobile Dual Arm Robotic Workers with Embedded Cognition for Hybrid and Dynamically Reconfigurable Manufacturing Systems, TOMAS. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you for sending us this presentation. Because of the delay we had at the beginning of this stream, we are going to skip the question and answer sessions for this presentations, and this the last presentation and the next one are from the same lab from University of Patras. That's why we are going to connect to